This video introduces the Ericsson LG iPex 1080i handset and will show you how to use your new phone on iPex Cloud. Your phone has five main components. These are the handset, the keypad, fixed buttons, HD video conferencing camera, and multi-touch LCD screen. Up to 48 flexible buttons are embedded within the touchscreen. First, we'll cover the basic features of your new iPex 1080i. Then we'll move on to more advanced features like the flex keys and soft keys. To answer your phone, simply lift the handset. Alternatively, to answer a call in speakerphone mode, press the speaker key. To place an external call, either lift the handset and dial the number, or dial the number and lift the handset to send the call. On some systems, you may need to dial a number first to get an outside line. Flex keys or flexible keys can be configured as speed dials or can be assigned to other phone system features. Flex keys assigned to internal extensions will illuminate when the monitored extension is busy. If the key flashes, the monitored extension is either ringing or in Do Not Disturb mode. There are 48 programmable keys in total, accessible across four pages. To select the additional pages, press the page number on the touchscreen. To answer a call on another extension, press the flashing flex key and then lift the handset. To place an internal call, you can either dial the extension number and lift the handset, or simply press the flex key assigned to the contact. To transfer a call to a colleague, press the transfer button, then dial the recipient's extension or external number. Or you can simply press the transfer button followed by the OK button, followed by the flex key for your colleague's extension. You can either speak to your colleague to announce a transfer or simply hang up to place a blind transfer. To create a conference call, call the first party. Once connected, touch the conference button on the touchscreen. You may need to press the arrow navigation. Now call the second party. Once you are connected to the second party, the conference will automatically start. To make a one-to-one video call, ensure your camera is turned on and touch the video button on the LCD screen. Dial the number and your video call will be automatically started. Please bear in mind this will only connect with another iPex 1080i handset or iPex One application with video enabled. You may need to select video again to turn on your camera. To park a call, press the transfer button and dial the park code, followed by the park location number. Then replace the handset. To retrieve a parked call, lift your handset, then dial the park code followed by the park location number. Park codes and location numbers are set up when the system is installed. Please note, park codes can be saved under a flex key for quick execution for this action. To access your voicemail, press the message button, followed by the voicemail option. You will be prompted for your password, followed by the number 2. If you're not sure of your password, please contact your system administrator. Once you are logged in, listen to the options and press the relevant number to manage your messages. Pressing the Do Not Disturb button puts the phone into Do Not Disturb mode, which declines all incoming calls and, if programmed, diverts incoming calls to voicemail. Activating Do Not Disturb when your phone is ringing will decline the current call and send the call to voicemail. The mute button can be pressed at any time during a call to mute your handset's microphone. The speaker and headset buttons toggle the audio output when in a call. Pressing the speaker button will switch the phone to speakerphone mode. The headset button activates headset mode. Audio can be returned to the handset by toggling headset or speakerphone modes off again. Your 1080i handset features a complete Android user system. As such, you can use it to download your favourite time-saving apps, adding even more functionality to your desk phone. Apps requiring GPS or portrait-only operation will not be suitable. The Android Back button takes you back to the previous screen. The Android Home button returns to the phone's home screen. You can add your favourite applications or widgets to the home screen. You can also add frequently used apps to the list on the left for easy access. The Android Overview button will display a preview of open applications on your device, allowing you to quickly switch between or close applications. Push the Android Home and then Menu button followed by the settings icon to access the advanced configuration menu of the phone. Here you can manage your wallpaper, system settings, apps and home screen settings. Pressing the directory button on your screen will open a list of your phone speed dials and contacts. These are divided into station speed dials, a directory stored only for your phone's extension, group speed, a company-wide directory maintained by your system administrator, and station name, an internal directory for colleague extensions within the business. Use the touchscreen to scroll through the contacts, or search for the contact you would like to call using the on-screen keyboard. Pressing the log button on your phone's home screen will display the history of calls you've made, received or missed. Scroll through the records to see more information on that call and select to dial the number. For more information on advanced features of your Ericsson LG iPex 1080i handset, please speak to your communications provider.